I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Yeah, what brings you out here today, ma'am, on tax day?
Oh, I'm just an average American citizen that wants to speak my mind about how the government's trying to take everybody over, and I don't like being branded racist because I'm nothing of that sort. And I care about my country deeply.
What do you think about the Long Island politicians who voted for the health care bill? What do you got to say to them?
They're going.
They're
voting
going?
Them out.
And who's your congressman in your district?
Bishop.
Bishop, okay.
Yes, Mr. Tim Bishop.
Right. So you're not happy with his performance,
Not
huh?
at all.
Right.
Not at all. Or Mr. Schumer.
Right. How about Ms. Gillibrand?
No, don't like her either, no.
So there's a whole bunch we got to get rid of in November,
Yes,
huh?
absolutely. If they don't listen, they have to go.
Right.
That's my feeling on it. And I wish more American people would pay attention, because our government's getting too big, and they're taking away our freedoms.
Right.
And that's my real concern. It's one of my real concerns. So that's why I'm here.
Thank you for coming out here. Really
thank
appreciate
you.
Your patriotism.
Thank you very much.
It's a really nice sign.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Sir, you have any comments you want to make to the politicians who voted for that health care bill?
Taxed enough.
Taxed enough, right.
No more. No we more. Can't afford it. We're bankrupt already.
Yeah. It didn't just start while they took us.
So what brings you out here today on tax day?
Trying to get this country back on track.
Right.
That's what we need to do, and look around and see all the people with the same thoughts.
Right, so how do you feel about when Nancy Pelosi calls you part of AstroTurf? What do you think about that?
I don't like it at all, because she should look in the mirror.
Right. Well, that might make the mirror crack. But
that's true.
That's Obama!
Hi. Hi.
You're teed off, huh?
I certainly am.
Very nice sign. So what do you say to this congressman who said they're doing it all for your own good?
Get the hell out of town before we chase you out of town.
Who's your congressman?
Tim Bishop, lying son of a bitch.
Don't hold back your feelings. You could just say,
met exactly with him three times and he smiles and he talks like a ventriloquist. He goes, I don't know what I'm going to do. I have no idea what I'm going to do.
He had no idea which way he was going to vote.
Oh, that's what he said?
He had already
Taxes?
Is that? He's lying,
not true at all.
Right.
And he's taking taxpayer money and spreading it around to
is
buy
he
votes.
Your congressman too?
Unfortunately, yes.
Right.
He is giving millions and hundreds of thousands to different districts, different communities, because he's buying votes. That's disgusting. Some person in Idaho is paying for my beach. I'm sorry, it's not right.
Right.
How can you pay taxes?
But what they did in the 60s is they changed from constitutionality being the main focus of laws to case law. Case law means whatever the guy says that day, and that sets a precedent. Well,
right.
If they were wrong, or if what they said in 1960 doesn't apply in 1990 or 2000, it should be taken off, it shouldn't be used. The Constitution follows the best rule of the world, keep it simple, stupid. It was four pages, covered everything. Forefathers were geniuses. And as I said, Obama, you're no George Washington. You were a constitutional lawyer, or student, constitutional professor, they say, but you don't know one thing about the Constitution. Czars or non-elected people are not allowed to control areas of the budget. If you go online and print out the pedigrees of his 31 czars, six of them are admitted communists, several of them believe Mao Zedong is the best person to review for advice, and most of them are anarchists and are for redistribution of the wealth.
So,
America was founded. America is the most generous country because when you do well, you're happy to share, you're happy to give back. If you tax us all so we can't eat or go to drive a car, we're not going to have anything to give back.
So you want original?
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today.
I like this one.
Right. Where's he taking us, Ernie?
I don't know, but I don't want to go there. We definitely don't want to go where Obama's taking us.
So what do you do with politicians who don't listen to the people?
We vote them out.
Yeah, right. That's the way.
In November.
Right.
Let it be a message, loud and clear, that comes November, those people that are supporting the Obama policies, we will do all our efforts to get rid of these people.
And who on Long Island particularly do you want to see go?
I have my list of the ones that we want to get rid of. We got Foley, who lied to me personally. I had coffee with Foley before he got elected, and this man is a liar. And we also got Steve Israel, and we got Bishop, and we got Schumer. Right. These are people I would really like to see go.
All right. Very good, Ernie.
All right.
Appreciate your comments.
Righto.
Thank you for coming out here.
He's got to come out of his shell, right?
Yeah, I know. He's in his shell. We got to get him out somehow. Yeah, maybe this will help. Let's see your sign here. Definitely. New tax. Yeah, speaking of new taxes, they're throwing around this VAT tax idea.
Oh, yeah.
What do you think of that?
Lovely. It's just what we need. More money out of our pockets.
Right.
We don't have enough now. And the guy is killing us with all these taxes.
Right.
The guy doesn't have a conscience. He doesn't care what he's doing to us. And he's just going to steamroll right over us, not giving a damn what it does to us.
Right.
So we've got to get rid of him as soon as we can.
Right.
We can't do it maybe this November when we get rid of some of his cronies. And then what is it, 2012?
Right.
We'll dump him too. Okay, his turn will come.
Well, if you keep up your determination like you're doing today, it looks like it's inevitable.
He certainly will. That's what these rallies are all about.
In spite of all the accusations of the media that you guys are racist and you're homophobes and all kinds of things.
Bull. Right?
That's not going to deter you, is it?
I've never met a better bunch of people than these people at the tea parties. Nobody causes a problem.
Right.
This is something that they are starting to make us look like we're trouble.
So you believe our story?
We are here because we do not like what this administration is doing to our country.
Okay.
We want to maintain our freedoms. We want to maintain the ability to control our own economic future. We're not looking for any kind of handouts.
Right.
We're not looking for any entitlements. There should be no entitlements.
We're going to destroy this nation. It's going to be taken down in debt. I don't know whether it's Cloward Cliven or whether they're just making a mess of this because they want to rebuild it in a different way.
So your concern goes beyond Long Island. You're concerned about the entire nation.
Absolutely.
Right.
And I'm out here for my grandchildren, not for me. I'm going to be gone.
Right.
You know, I don't have that long left. So.
They're going to socialize this nation, and I can't even imagine how these people have not figured out that socialism has failed in every place that has ever been tried in the world.
Right.
You know, if we don't learn from history, we're doomed to the same result.
And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
What brings you out here today?
To support the Tea Party movement for less taxes. I don't want to burden our future generations with the debt we have right now.
Right, right. And this is not something you usually do, huh? This is something.
This is my first event ever.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay. Well, congratulations. Welcome to the Tea Party movement.
Thank you. It's nice to get involved.
Thank you. Nice to see you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
So, sir, what brings you out today on tax day?
Tired of paying all these taxes. I got better things to do with my money. My family needs my money. My children are going to college.
Right.
They need money for a down payment for their house.
Right.
It's getting tough to afford all these things.
Right. So you think the Long Island politicians aren't listening to the people out here?
Oh, absolutely not. That's why I'm carrying this sign over here.
A Steve Israel must go.
And here's another sign to that.
Oh, Pelosi yesterday.
Right. He's listening to Pelosi. He's not listening to the people.
Right. Right, so you plan on staying active throughout the election cycle?
For the rest of my life.
Wow.
I was active before, but I've become ultra active now because I'm seeing my country slip away.
Right, do you feel our Constitution is being violated by these guys?
Absolutely. There's no question about it. We have a constitution for a reason, to protect the people. We're supposed to govern what goes on in this country and not the other way around.
Right.
We have too many backroom deals going on in Congress and the Senate. and in this administration. And unless the people step up, they're going to take this country away from us.
Well, thanks for coming out here. Really appreciate your patriotism and determination.
Go CSA! Go Tea Party!
Yes, sir. The News 12 just interviewed you. What about?
Well, they want to know my feelings about why I'm here and my concerns.
Right. And why are you here?
Well, I'm here mainly for my children and the direction of the country. I feel that the country is going in the wrong direction. And I'm scared for my kids. I'm scared for myself. I feel that I'm not being properly represented by my congressman. And anything I can do to turn this country around and go in the right direction, I will do it.
Right.
Come election day, I'm getting up early. I'm going to call up everybody and anybody I know. I'm going to knock on doors. I'm going to bring people down to drive them down to the polling place.
And what's your message to the politicians on Long Island who voted for the health care bill?
All of them?
Yeah.
Adios.
Okay.